Initiate. You'll hear the word project a great deal at EY, in many different ways. But what exactly does it mean? Well, looking at a dictionary explanation, we read, an individual or collaborative enterprise planned and designed to achieve an aim. Or we could just say, it's pretty much everything we do in life. What's important to remember is that a project is a process with a definite start and end. And the first step in the life cycle is to initiate the project. This is the start of the process, the stage where you establish why we need a project to happen and if it's feasible. It's the big picture stage of the process, where a project charter is established. If there's a clear need, we need to know how it might be done and who needs to be involved, because once we know the aim of the work, we can start looking at ways to achieve our goal. One thing is certain, it needs to be managed successfully from day one by a superhero, I mean a project manager. Let's not get carried away just yet. Once this initial stage is agreed by the client, we will begin to draw together a team of key people to deliver the project and move into the next key stage of planning. Plan. Once we establish why and if a project can go ahead, it's time to start moving into how the project might evolve. Get a snapshot of what you need to achieve and use this as a baseline to determine how you might achieve it. By getting an idea of how long things might take, how much it will cost, and what might go wrong along the way, you'll be able to start producing a project management plan and scope which should be constantly reviewed and updated. This is the time to get an experienced team together, break the work down into individual tasks, create a schedule, and assign the tasks to each team member. By this stage, you should be able to assess the risks, make assumptions, tackle issues, and see which task is dependent on the next taking place. Oh, and most importantly, don't forget what your client is trying to achieve. All these elements combine into a project plan which becomes the firm foundation on which to build and carry out the work. Execute. By now, we know why, we've confirmed if, and we've planned how the project might happen. So we can move on to the next stage. Execute. We have kickoff, and it's all systems go. Teams and resources become integrated, and the plans start to take shape. In an ideal world, things will go exactly to your plan, with no obstacles. However, projects are rarely that straightforward, and you may have to face different issues every day. From a delivery not getting through, to a client changing their requirements. Part of this process is managing any uncertainties and requests for change. But because of the groundwork you've done, it should be clear to see what impact these things will have on the original plan. The key thing is to ensure that the outcome has to be what the client wants and expects. With all your research, your team's knowledge, and your detailed planning, you should be able to change and adapt to whatever comes your way. Monitor and control. As the project begins to build and grow, it's crucial to monitor, control, and watch it all take shape. Ensuring things are on track and any necessary changes are taken into account is vital at this stage of the process. Imagine if there was no one monitoring the project. How would you know if the original objectives were being met, any change requests were implemented, and if the quality is to standard? Managing your project team, scope, schedule, cost, risks, issues, and stakeholders will achieve the desired project outcome. Keeping everyone involved and up to date is also an important step at this stage. Reporting back is key to success, and it's vital to get approval and assurance whenever necessary. If the project is doing well, let your client know. It's essential they hear the positive and not just the negative. It's very easy at this stage to take your eye off the ball, especially if things are going exactly to plan. But don't make that mistake. Keep tracking the benefits and logging progress, and above all, keep watching. close. Phew, you finished. The end. The client has sent you their full approval and agreed it's what they wanted and they're happy. It's all too easy to congratulate yourself and the team, admire your work and close the book. But during every project, we learn vital lessons about project objectives and client expectations. If we don't communicate and reflect on these lessons by reviewing how the project went, we don't build on our experience for future ventures. Structured feedback from the client and across the project team can only strengthen our working relationships. Sharing knowledge and deciding what worked well and what could be improved can only help change things for the better. In other words, it's constructive to be deconstructive. Healthy feedback and a look at key moments throughout your recent work will pave the way for further successful projects in the future. If you want to take a more formal and comprehensive course on project management, go to EY Leeds for more information.